Damn. Hey Karma family, a very happy Saturday to each and every one of you. I'm late today. I got so busy doing everything that you could even imagine, cooking, baking, prepping. I finally glanced over at the clock and I'm like, Lord have mercy, it's 7:30. I told my Karma family I'd have my video up. I better get my behind in there and get to doing something. Y'all, just a little update. This morning, yes, Mr. Karma, he got the hint. I got me a 20 flavor box of Jelly Bellies, and I've had a few. I ain't gonna lie, I've had more than a few. You know how, like, you take a couple, let me try this flavor, let me try this. Oh, this flavor here looks good. I probably had a good 30 of them, at least. And my stomach is feeling it. My stomach is like, wait a minute, girl, you done cut me off of all sugar. And now you gonna load me up with some damn Jelly Belly jelly beans. Whew. So yeah, my stomach's a little bit, I'm not sick to my stomach, but it's like, So I will not be having any more. I won't be having any more tonight, put to you that way. But I hope everyone is getting ready for Easter. Listen, like I said, the extra people that are coming, I got no problem with it because everyone is family. It's all family. So it's like, listen, okay, I'm going to do, oh, let me tell you what I made. I know we're going to get to Pinky. Pinky is making lunch, chatting old times. And pretty much old times is just basically same old shit, recycled, you know, same old boring stuff. But it's from March 27th of last year. And old Pinky hasn't uploaded because I made sure to check. I thought, wait a minute, before, because I knew I wanted to do this video. But I thought, before I do this video, let me see if she has uploaded. Nope. Still hadn't uploaded. Anyway, I guess Pinky's busy. Before we get to Pinky, let me tell you, the one dessert that I've made so far, because I gotta do another one tonight. I did a coconut cream poke cake. I just took a yellow box cake, yellow Pinky, not white, a yellow box cake. As soon as it came out of the oven, I punched, I poked, but I made the holes, you know, kind of big. Then while I let that sit for about 15 minutes, did up the coconut cream pudding, and then, you know, I made sure to get that pudding all down in them holes, and then I poured the rest of it over the top of the cake, and I made sure to get it all down on the sides of the cake, you know, get it all down through there. Then I toasted up some coconut, and I sprinkled a little toasted coconut over the top of that. Then I put the Cool Whip on top of it. Then I just took and I sprinkled the rest of that toasted coconut on top of that, put it in the refrigerator, and I'm telling you right now, I know. I've done it before with banana pudding, but I love coconut. Oh, my Lord, have mercy. I love coconut. I love toasted coconut. I mean, I could eat that stuff by the handfuls. I didn't. I didn't this time because, you know, the Jelly Bellies pretty much fixed me. But I know come tomorrow that is going to be some bomb dessert. Like I said, I got to do another one up. But I figured, well, I got to at least do a couple of them because, you know, my family likes to eat, and I have no problem with that because I love having people to dinner who love to eat because, trust me, I make a boatload of food. I make sure no one is leaving my house that they aren't, you know, tugging at their pants or, you know, the women are like, oh, Lord have mercy. I don't think I'd be able to eat for a week. That's right. That's what I want to hear. So that was my one dessert. But anyway, let's get to our girl Pinky here. Making lunch, chatting, old times. Yeah, just like old times, Pinky. And yes, I've already given my little extra Easter contribution.
Guys, welcome back to my channel. So today,
well, I tell you what, sometimes you got to almost be prepared when she pops her big ass head on camera. Let's watch that again. Boy, if that didn't up, that almost gave me a little bit of a jolt.
Welcome back to my channel. So today I've gotten 2 loads of clothes in, and now I'm getting ready to make some lunch. I had a couple eggs, egg sandwich this morning. So that's what I've did so far. Not really too much. Lay down and have me a little nap. Now it's time for some lunch. I think I'm just going to do a salad. I got some pre-made salad in there. Thought, why not? That'd be good.
Now, y'all already know that this is way after. This was just a year ago. Let me show you. March 27th, 2023. Pinky had already claimed that she was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. Mm-hmm. And let's take a look. Look at that head. Y'all done seen the side view. Does that look like anyone who, you know, was told you need to cut out all pop? Not just some pop, she told us. The doctor said all pop. But then she went to, but if you're going to drink, you know, diet pop, drink the clear kind. Yeah, you remember that? Does that look like someone who has cut out sugar? I mean, even if she had cut out half of sugar, you would think this would all be, you know, a lot smaller. I mean, you would think.
It's the big ones. Got up and had a shower this morning, brushed my teeth, had a little wash up. That's called shower. Not too bad outside.
Nope. That's a weight gain, not a weight loss. There's a difference, Pinky. Now, I don't know what day this was actually, that she actually recorded this. But she said she got up, she had her couple egg sandwiches, you know, on that split top wheat bread that she just adores. Then she laid down and took a nap. Then she got up, brushed her teeth, washed off. And then she says, well, I guess I'd shower. No, girl, washing off, like in the sink, and taking a shower is two separate things. Two separate things. The only thing I do out of the bathroom sink, I mean, I assume that you did this out of the bathroom sink. I hope you're not brushing your teeth and doing all that in the kitchen sink. Only thing I do in the bathroom sink, I brush my teeth, and before I go to bed, I wash my face. When I get up in the morning, I wash my face. That's it. The rest of me is hitting in the shower. Ain't getting washed in the sink, in the bathroom sink. I'm sorry, girl. My behind is in the shower to wash all, you know, my nether parts. So.
The sun's on out. Well, the sun's been out off and on, but not too much. It's sprinkling a tad bit here and there, but that's about it. Okay, you guys. I'm going to get my salad. That's strawberries here, too. So, we'll try some strawberries. And my salad down here. This stuff probably needs to be thrown away. Been in there for ever. Long time. I got some salad back here. Oh, I got some salad back here somewhere. There it is. I don't really care. Whole lot for the Caesar dressing. So, got my own dressing down here. So much better to have your own dressing. We got some pastry drawers, you guys. Love them. This one's a little bit longer one. It has a handle on it too. For the middle. These ones have lifts. So I got them at Walmart's. So you can go to Walmart's and get yous. Okay. That one ain't been open. This one ain't been open. This one's been open.
See, Pinky just has a single refrigerator now, which there's you know, there's nothing wrong with that. But compared to that, you know, that big two-door, you know, the side-by-side refrigerator she had, you know, at the old house. She had to downsize because she says, you know, that there wasn't any room for a side-by-side in the McMansion. I don't know about that. I think she could do a side-by-side there. I really think she could. But she left the refrigerator. She left the refrigerator, the stove. She left that stuff there. I think maybe because it would have, you know, fetched a little bit more money. I mean, I guess. I don't know. But, yeah, that's why she's got these drawers up here. I tell you what, I love a side-by-side refrigerator. That's what I have. And I still sometimes struggle to find room in that bad boy. I tell you what, there's times I get in there and it's like you got to root around. It's like I know damn well that I bought sour cream. It don't make any difference how organized you try to do it. You open that damn, you get organized it one day, the next day you get in there and you're like, I know damn well that the sour cream should be, you know, right here where, you know, where this stuff is, it don't do any good. I just figure, you know what, as long as it gets cleaned out, you know, anything that gets spilled or, you know, anything like that, not by me, because I'm not a messy person like that. But have you ever taken your damn refrigerator apart? You know, you take the drawers out, you know, but you want to wash them with a little bit of bleach, preferably, Pinky, you know, in case you're listening. And the glass, you ever see down there in them damn creases and everything, and you think to yourself, how in the hell did, like, how did that get down in there? And I'll tell you what, some of those things are not easy to clean. I don't care. I'm taking the glass out, and it's still like, it's like you still can't get into it. I mean, you got to pretty much you got to tear the whole refrigerator apart. The glass has got to come out, the drawers, the hand, every damn thing's got to come off to be able to get that damn thing super clean. But anyway, but you know what, Pinky? That is a good idea to do as far as that, considering that, I mean, as much as y'all go to the, I don't know why you would need extra drawers, Pinky, because, I mean, you can't really seem to keep a whole lot of food in the refrigerator because, I mean, y'all go to the grocery store, like, at least 4 times a week, so.
Bacon. Supposed to make cheeseburgers, but we'll see if I feel like making any or not. I made that Coke. Got these out to make some.
Yeah, and again, you notice the Diet Coke. It's not clear. It's not clear Diet Coke. You know, it's not the you know, the sugar-free Sprite. Because, Pinky, that's what you said. You said the doctor said, well, you know, if you do have to have some Diet Pop, that's how you put it. I can't imagine a doctor saying Pop. But anyway, but that's what you told us. You said, the doctor said, I have to cut out all sugar and I have to cut out all Diet Pop. And then I think it was like a week and a half later when you couldn't contain yourself from coming, you know, coming on and always having a Diet Coke there with you. Then you changed it to, I'm still drinking it and I'm really, really trying. But the doctor did tell me that, you know, if I had to have Diet Pop, that to have the clear kind. As you sat there with a regular Diet Coke in front of you. Did that make any sense? Yeah, if I have to have Diet Pop, she said I can have the clear as I'm sitting here with a regular Diet Coke in front of you all. Boy, look at that mess. Look at them hands. Look at them fingers. Mm. Now I don't know. To me, they at this point in time, they look, you know, they look swollen. But yeah. Mm-hmm.
Low carb pizzas. Okay. I think that's about what I need right there. Looks good to me. Kind of my favorite way to make a salad.
You notice the breathing? Mm-hmm. You can hear that breathing. All she's doing is standing there and turning to bend over to get the stuff from the refrigerator, standing up, and then turning to the right to sit the stuff down on the on the counter, the block thing, what a butcher's block, whatever the hell it is. That's it. She's not walking 20, 30, 40 steps to get this stuff and then walking 20, 30, 40 steps back. She's just standing there and out of breath. Hands looking, I mean, hell, them hands are bigger than Mr. Karma's hands, and Mr. Karma got some big-ass hands on him. While talking about, I'm going to fix a low-carb pizza. And make it make sense, Jesus.
Right. It's a cottage cheese. If I really don't want that chicken in there, definitely don't want this. Hey guys, here we go. Sorry. I have my bag in here. Angle for fruit comes in. A little bit of carb.
And got that big-ass bucket of cottage cheese. And you also told us as far as that, you know, you had to cut back on the cottage cheese. When have we ever seen Pinky not have or be at the store buying cottage cheese? I don't understand. Somebody needs to, someone has to explain the definition of cutting back to Pinky, or someone needs to, I don't know, maybe have a talk with the doctor and say, listen, you need to explain when you tell Pinky that she needs to cut back or that she shouldn't be having it. See, you need to define that stuff for her because clearly she does not understand. And it's nice to see you at least have a bra on in this video, Pinky. It's not a very sturdy bra, but it is a bra, probably a sports bra, but at least, you know, at least they're not hanging down, you know, way down south. They just kind of, you know, y'all know when she doesn't have a bra on, them bad boys be, you know, they be down to about where that the bottom of that fork is.
They got these big pieces of romaine.
like watching paint dry. These salads, okay, these salads, I mean, they're okay if you just something, if you know, I don't know, you're on your lunch break and you just need something, one little something healthier, need something quick or something. I mean, okay as far as that. But this stuff, like for the Caesar salads, you ever open that damn thing up, and just like she was taking, you know, they get the big end pieces, they got the hard pieces and everything, and I've done it myself, Pinky. You stand there, and you're like, no, I don't want this, no, I don't want all that and everything. And by the time you are done picking that stuff out of there, you've damn near taken half away the lettuce. You've taken half away the salad. And it's like, this isn't, you know, I mean, it's much, much cheaper, Pinky. Go buy you some romaine lettuce. You do buy romaine lettuce. You used to buy a lot of it. And make your own damn Caesar salad, you know. You like that canned chicken, so there you go. You get you some romaine lettuce. You get you some of that old funky canned chicken. And, you know, there you go. You get your ranch, your croutons, your cottage cheese and everything. And bang, bang, bangity, bang, boom. You got you your kind of Caesar salad. That's all you got to do. That's a lot of cottage cheese for that salad. That's not a ton of lettuce either. That's a, And then I think what makes my stomach turn with it, you know, is she, when she puts that ranch on it. And I think it's just the combination of what the ranch dressing looks like on top of this, on top of the cottage cheese, that is like, no, that's a no for me. I can't, I don't know. I just don't like the way it looks. Might taste good. I mean, it really might. And there's probably other people who add cottage cheese to their salads. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. I'm just saying when you add ranch dressing on top of it, it's just like, you'd almost think you could eliminate the ranch, Pinky. I mean, you got the cottage cheese there. Hell, use that as your dressing. You know, and then she don't add cheese on top, regular cheese on top of it. So it's like, why would you even, as much cottage cheese as she puts in there, why would you need a dressing? You buy that ranch seasoning, sprinkle a little bit of that on there. And then you kind of have the taste of, like, you have ranch dressing, but you don't. See that right there, you know, she just took and she just took and ate from the bowl, from this container. Now look, maybe she's the only person who eats that cottage cheese, and if that's the case, if nobody else eats that cottage cheese but her, then go for it, Pinky. Eat out of that bitch all you want to, you know, but that just kind of turns my stomach, because it's like, see, that's a no-no in my house. I better not catch anybody drinking out of the milk, no. We aren't barnyard animals. I better not ever catch anybody doing some nasty stuff like that, because it's like, you know, y'all, some of you out there will know what I'm talking about. But I guess if you're the only person who eats this, then all fine and well. But you know, when you're watching something and someone does something like that, and you just make this face, you just cringe, like, oh, I know she just didn't eat out of that container. Now who else is going to come along and, you know, want them some cottage cheese or something, and then she don't have the spoon in her mouth and then put the damn thing back in the cottage cheese?
Best salad ever, y'all. Right here. Love it. I'm gonna eat all this, but you know, I'll give it a try. Why not, right?
Why not? That's right, Pinky. Why not? I mean, you eat everything else that you bring into the McMansion. Hell, I mean, I have no doubt whatsoever that you can't take down that bowl of salad. Listen, Pinky, I could buy me one of these salads and eat the whole damn thing up. So, I mean, that's really no big deal. It's just the combination of stuff that you put in there. But trust me, you're going to finish it all. And then you'll probably be heading back to the refrigerator or something else.
What you down below, what you guys all have for lunch. Give me something healthy.
Yeah, hey, my viewers and everything, while I'm sitting here, you know, and I'm probably about 450 pounds at the time I was doing this video, and I'm having my salad, and I got the croutons in there, and, you know, and I'm even bigger than I was 6 months ago, let me know what you all are eating. You know, hey, listen, if it is healthy and it's low carb, yes, then send it my way. Make it make sense. Send it your way for what, Pinky? Basically, like sending you something to wipe your ass with, because, I mean, I mean, that would be a waste of time. Why even ask somebody to do that? And then, you know, you got Debbie from, I don't know, in Georgia or something saying, oh, hey, I know some good healthy recipes. And Debbie probably maybe on her phone, you know. And trust me, I had to do that not too long ago on my phone and everything and trying to type in and stuff like that. I'm not one of these whizzes. You know, you see some people, they get their thumbs going and stuff, and you think to yourself, Jesus, I mean, are you actually spelling words right going that fast? So, yeah, I'm not a fasty like that, you know. I got the index finger going, you know. I'm like, let me check up here, make sure I spelled that damn thing right. So you got Debbie sitting there. You know, it might take her an hour. I'm just saying, I'm assuming. It might take her an hour to type, you know, these healthy recipes for her to leave in a comment to Pinky. And then for Pinky to just, you know, kind of look at it, I ain't eating that. Again, I mean, no respect whatsoever.
Yes, please. Good to see everyone. So glad you guys enjoyed my channel.
You know what? That hair. That just always. Listen, Pinky, it's your McMansion. It's your McTable. It's your McSalad. Do whatever you want. But I tell you what, just that constant with that hair, that long stringy ass hair and stuff, and it's like, especially at the kitchen table, because y'all know, I got long hair, you know, and there'll be sometimes, you know, like, I'll be over there, like, wiping around a thing, and I think to myself, Lord, I'm really big, oh, this is my hair. Hair comes out, and for the most part, my hair, I keep it up in a ponytail. But to sit down at the kitchen table, where you have food in front of you, and just to be sitting there, basically taking them big ass, that bear paw, them big ass bear, nubby stubby fingers, going through that stringy ass hair, you know that that hair is getting all over the place, probably all in the food and everything, and it's like, no, again, that's just me, it's just me, no, ain't nobody, don't be playing with the hair. No, wait, but we don't play with hair. We don't do nothing like that at the dinner table when there's food on the table. People want to enjoy the beef stew, the whatever we're having, and they don't want strands of hair in their food. Thank you very much. Look at her. She was triggered about something. You can just tell how she makes that face. She's triggered. Boy, Pinky, I wish, you know, sometimes I sit there and think to myself, boy, I just want to go in and find all the videos where you were like really, really triggered and stuff, because I've always said ain't nothing like having a triggered Pinky. I mean, you can just tell, look at her. Yeah, I'm glad you all are enjoying my channel. Well, not so much.
I tell you what, YouTube stuff's not easy sometimes. That really truly is it. But
you got a little something on your cheeky there, Pinky. Yeah, this YouTube stuff, boy. Oh, it's so hard. It really, really is hard. I mean, you just would never ever know, you know. You ever notice how you never hear a reactor saying that? You never hear a reactor saying, as far as you know, boy, Lord have mercy, this reacting is just hard. It's just hard for me to sit my ass down and put this video up and for me just to, you know, I don't know, complain, talk shit, laugh, joke, do anything like that. It's just so hard. Damn, y'all, it's so hard. And again, Pinky, it's so hard for you to sit there and eat your salad and basically talk about nothing. Yeah, that's real hard. Probably the hardest part is to, you know, to continue to keep coming up with the lies that we always catch you in.
You know, I try to do the best that I can. I really honestly do. I know, my life's kind of boring. It is.
How many times have we heard that? How many times have we heard that, you know? I really, really try. I try so hard, guys. I really, really do. No, you don't, Pinky. You don't try whatsoever. You know, this is just a thing to come on to get a little sympathy from some of her viewers to say, oh, Pinky, we love your content. We love your cooking. We love your baking. We love everything about you, Pinky. We just really, really do. You know, to get, you know, a couple pats on the behind. That's all it was for. Because you don't try. You don't try.
But, oh well. I have weight loss surgery. Some of you all.
I have weight loss surgery. Some of you all. Does that make any sense? I have weight loss surgery. Some of you all.
I probably won't either.
I have weight loss surgery. Some of you all probably won't either. I don't even get where she's going with that. I really don't. I don't know. Maybe it'll come back, or I probably need somebody. I probably need mayhem. I need somebody. Bohemian. I say it both ways. I really, really do. Bohemian. I don't know why I say bohemian. Bohemian. I think about anyone who's new to Karma Family. Have I ever told you how much I love Freddie Mercury of Queen? Bohemian Rhapsody. So I don't know why in the hell I say Bohemian sometimes. See, Pinky, you know, I'm not perfect either. You know, there's things I don't say right. I mean, I'm not as, you know, I'm not anywhere near in your categories as far as the way you say stuff. But anyway, Bohemian. And I think to myself, Bohemian. Girl, because sometimes I think to myself, I feel like I'm screwing that up. The more I try to get it into my brain cells, I just really feel like I'm screwing up. I'm gonna have to come up with a cute little nickname for you. I really am. But anyway, I hope Mr. Twilight is, I hope Mr. Twilight is okay. And you probably came back in when you had said that. Lord have mercy, that was a week and a half ago, and I just didn't see it. But let me say this much right now. I hope that he is okay. I hope that whatever was wrong, that he's feeling much better. Mr. Twilight, if you are watching this video with your beautiful wife, I love her, and I hope that you are doing well. So shout out to you, Mr. Twilight. And I'm sorry, if you are watching this video, you're probably thinking to yourself, you really had to pause on this woman right here in this position in order for you to ask me if I'm feeling all right or hoping I'm feeling all right. Well, I'm not feeling all right now. I'm kind of sick to my stomach because you got me looking at Pinky like this. And I apologize.
We shall see. I probably won't either. We shall see. What the future holds us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was triggered. I can't remember. But this was, again, March 2023. This was a year, a little over a year, just a smidge, because it was in, what was it, January, February? Yeah, early March that she claimed she was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. Mm-hmm. This was a year later. Again, look at the face, look at the head. Yep, just like old times. Seems like old times. Remember that? Y'all ever seen that movie, Seems Like Old Times? Just like old times, Pinky. Old times, old lies. I think that's going to be the title of this video.
I have water with my salad. I'm going to cook a little bit later. Yes, I will. Oh, you guys. You wouldn't believe what someone sent me yesterday. A picture of myself and my brother who passed away years ago. And we were both smaller, like way smaller. I was like 5 or 6 when my eye happened. And I still wear my eye patch. So cool to see. Because as you know, growing up, we had 2 house fires, so all of our pictures got burnt. All my mom's old, you know, pictures and that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And making it even more better, the picture was taken right here in this mobile home. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right over by that refrigerator. Well, where the refrigerator's sitting at now. Of course, there was a different one there then, but yeah, very neat, huh? I thought it was. I thought it was pretty cool.
Oh, wow. Ooh, what a coinky dinky dinky. You never showed us that picture, Pinky. Yeah, old times, old lies. Damn, that's a good title of this video. Old times, old lies. You've never shown that picture, Pinky. You've said about... Yeah, excuse me, y'all, if you can hear Mr. Karma blowing his nose. He blow his nose, he'd be halfway down the hall in another room and you can hear him. Anyway, you know, allergies. You've never shown that picture, Pinky. Maybe you forgot. Okay, let's give Pinky the benefit of the doubt. She probably forgot. But Pinky, I know you'll be watching this video, so you know, it'll remind you. And then you'll come out and you'll show us that video. Or, yeah, show us that video. You'll show us that picture. Mm-hmm. Like I said, Pinky does this stuff whenever you can tell. You can tell when you hit the nail on the head about somebody. And it's just so, so weird that anytime I ever talked about that eye, it's like, oh, Pinky, you know, that's a lazy eye, you know. And she'll come out and she'll do this kind of stuff, you know. Oh, somebody sent me a picture of me and my brother, you know. And, yeah, I'll have to show that to you guys. But never ever did, Pinky. I mean, how, Pinky, if somebody sent you the picture and it's just like you're talking about it, all you'd have to do is be like, oh, well, hold on a second, guys. I mean, I got it on my laptop. I mean, I would assume they sent it to you in an email. Here it is. Here it is. But no, still haven't seen it. You know, I don't know. But like I said, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. You know, maybe you forgot. Maybe it slipped your mind. But, you know, I know you'll be watching this video, so... Especially when you see old times, old lies. Yeah, because you're like going to be like thinking to yourself, oh, Lord have mercy, what now? Now what she catch me in? Which lie did she catch me in this time? Not lie, girl. Lies. Lies. But maybe you'll show it to us. I mean, I'd like to see it. I mean, you've talked about that eye and, you know, just, I mean, how horrible it was when that pin, you know, went into it and, you know, you had to wear that eye patch and everything like that. Mm. You know, you've said many times about it. So, you have a picture of you and your brother, and you have the eye patch on, then you can show it to us, you know? And then it'll be like, oh, well, guess what? She wasn't lying. Well, damn, I'm sorry, Pinky, you know? But one thing, Pinky, we know what Halloween costumes look like, okay? So just so you know that, you know? Don't be coming on here with a pirate outfit on when you was a kid and saying, yeah, this is me. No, we ain't falling for that. Uh-uh. No, girl.
I'm on my phone right now, but I'm filming from my phone.
Yeah, I always on my phone right now, but, you know, I'm filming from my phone, and, yeah. You could have edited it in. You know, you could have did your little editing right there, Pinky. You know, pretty easy to do. Pretty easy to do.
I was so skinny. Like I said, I really didn't start gaining weight until about my teenage years. Not a teenager, middle school, whatever. That's when I started really getting weight. Other than that, I was.
Mm-hmm. I don't believe that, Pinky. I don't believe that. You know, I don't believe that for 1 second, girl.
I wasn't big as a kid at all. This guy by me full.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, yeah. Did you get big when you got pregnant with Haley? Is that when you picked up your weight? Ugh, let me see. I'm gonna have a grab that as a screenshot. Hold on a second. Yeah, so let's see. Let's cover your lies just in this one. The fact that, you know, type 2 diabetes, but yet, you know, sitting at about 450 pounds, clearly had been, well, whatever you were supposed to have been doing for a year, you hadn't been doing, you just continued to get bigger and bigger and bigger. Talking about your low carb, lie. Talking about the picture that you were going to show everybody of you and your brother, and, you know, you had the eye patch on, lie. Never did show the picture. Again, Pinky, if you have proof that, as far as your eye from when you were a child, when that happened, which you claim that you have that, you claim that you have a picture of you and your brother, and you're wearing the eye patch, all you gotta do is come out and just show it, you know? And that'll be one thing that I, you know, we'll just put a little check there and say, you know, well, look, she told the truth as far as this. So, listen, Pinky, my bad. I'm not afraid to, you know, I'm not gonna backtrack it and be like, you know, oh, you proved me wrong. I've been saying you were a liar. Well, look, I was wrong. So, listen, hey, girl, you were right. I apologize. I'm not afraid to apologize if I'm wrong. Hell, I do that in everyday life. If I'm wrong about something, I'll be the first one to admit it. But you're not going to be able to do that, Pinky. You're not going to be able to do that. I don't think so. You know, you was triggered by something in this video. I can't remember from that long ago. I really can't. It's hard to say. But we clearly know that you haven't shown any proof as far as your eye. You really, to date, have not shown really any proof as far as your type 2 diabetes. Yeah, you sure as hell haven't shown any proof as far as losing any kind of weight. This low-carb journey lifestyle that you've been on. Haven't shown anything as far as that, so, yeah. Old times, old lies. It is what it is. It is what it is. Karma family, I'm going to end this here. From my family to your family, I hope each and every one of you have a beautiful Easter, a very happy Easter to each and every one of you. As I always say, I hope that you are surrounded by the people that you love. Listen, even if you just have your fur baby, hey, you're with someone that you love, and that fur baby loves you. And I hope that each and every one of you, that you have a beautiful meal. That, listen, try not to eat too many jelly beans, jelly beans in general. Like I said, I'm not eating anymore tonight. Now, tomorrow is a different story. But right now, my stomach is, my stomach's like, don't do it, girl. Don't play with me as far as these damn jelly beans. I'll have you in that damn bathroom right quick. Karma family, I love you all. I love each and every one of you. A very, very happy Easter. And hopefully Pinky will put something up, but I'll be back, as always. Love you all. Catch you in the next one. Bye.